Hey guys.
Hey guys.
Hello, we're back. This is what we're going to do tonight with you guys is something that we'd like to continue doing. Something, the first of a few, hopefully, a first of a bunch. We're going to listen to a song, in this case, one that we've already chosen. Listen to it with you guys if you want to listen to it with us. The song Happy Birthday is the one we're going to do tonight.
That was blue.
Oh my gosh. See, we were thinking of doing see guys. This is for real. It's for real. Just bleep it out.
The song we're gonna do tonight.
We were choosing between Happy Birthday and Blue, and we all decided to do Blue. So Blue is the song that we're gonna do. And yeah, you love me.
I can't. Well, yeah, it's great.
I'm an idiot. I love it.
No, it makes me feel so much better. I'm like so relaxed now. I'm like, thank God she did it.
I don't mind looking stupid. This is something that I think y'all already probably know. So yeah, we're gonna listen to Blue, and we're gonna talk about it. We're gonna kind of go back to Blue. And
when was the last time we all sat down together and listened to Blue?
No,
we don't. I don't think we never sat down and listened to. I don't think any of our songs together in any sort of critical after the fact like appraisal kind of way.
Yeah.
But that's because we're usually on to the next thing. So this is kind of fun. That's why we're doing it.
Yeah. Especially live. I mean, we play Blue live so many times, right? Like, Blue has been part of our interactions with each other.
Forever.
But not the recorded version. So that'd be interesting.
Actually, that's true. The one thing I do notice is, don't you guys find, like, when we play, we've been touring, especially these early songs, like from Violet and Nothing and Nowhere and that stuff for so long. It's like you get used to how it sounds live. Mm-hmm. And sometimes when you like, and we don't really throw on our own records or, you know, before we're getting ready for shows, we're listening to other bands, you know, like we don't really, we listen to our own stuff enough because we're playing it all the time. So we get used to the live version. And then sometimes when I listen to the kind of the album version, if it ever comes up at some given time, it's always really almost foreign to me.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, there might be some like
just the production so different, the guitar sounds, especially some things like Red Stars, don't you find? Like certain heavy songs especially.
Meaning that we've been doing it wrong live, and it's interesting to hear how the song is actually supposed to sound.
Well, I think live is it's an evolved version of it though. Sometimes I kinda wish I could marry the two. There's certain things production wise from songs on albums that I think is like, you know, it's different live, but then you get used to the live version, especially our guitar textures and stuff. I find it's just, you get used to hearing it off stage. Anyway,
so
I'm beating this point to death.
What we're going
to
do is we're going to pull up the song, and we're going to listen. We're going to sit here, and we're going to listen to it.
Yeah.
And you guys can listen to it, too, if you want. You can also fast forward if you're
really selling this.
If you want to get to the meat.
If you want to get to the meat and taters.
We'll be right back.
To clap for yourself.
I wasn't sure.
Yeah, now you know.
Now I know.
Thanks. I haven't listened to that version of the song in a long time.
Yeah, I was when I was listening to it, I was wondering if that was the mix, like we would these like right now that like I want to like start moving stuff and EQing stuff. And, but that's just because
you're a perfectionist.
No,
and because it was done so long ago.
It's also just that itch to change it. It's like the charm and the sometimes it's lost on the person that recorded it because you're always your perspective's different.
What was like the number one thing that you would have changed if you could?
I find just there's a brightness. I feel like a lot of our stuff. I like our stuff to be mixed and produced very spacious and a nice high end to it, but all, like. And clarity. I feel like this album, like we did our best. Like, it's you know.
What year did this song come out?
This was like 2000. Yeah.
2005.
Okay, so.
It's anyway, but okay. Yeah, I think
it's on the original version, the EP as well, right?
Yeah, it's the mastering, the mixing. I mean, it could even just be the mastering of it. I just feel like there's a certain like high end sparkle that's kind of. Missing to it, but I feel like that mix, the way we used to mix, we do stuff so evenly, if you brought that out of it, everything would have that. Like, you kind of only want certain instruments to have those characteristics.
Yeah, for sure.
So, I feel like the guy mastering this was probably like, well, I can't, like, you know what I mean? It's our mixing,
you
or, you know, I remember at the time, too, when we mixed this song, or the Violet album, I remember I rented those Yamaha. Mike, those like Yamaha speakers.
Oh, the NS10s?
I don't even know. Just something from Long McQuay.
I don't think they were even that good.
No. They weren't. It was,
the bottom of the barrel.
We did it at, you know, but they were kind of the industry standard, you know, like whatever. Nothing too fancy, but.
Yeah.
And anyway, but yeah, it's. We were doing the best we could, and it was. And honestly, it was. That was quite evolved past from where we were with the 4-track. And, in that day and age, that was.
Well, this was the first album that you guys kind of went into. Did you do it at Phase One for the EP?
We did some recording at Phase One, which is like
a
big studio in Toronto. I don't know if it's still around.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Is it still around?
It's got to be.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Did it?
Name might have changed, but I mean.
It was a few years ago. It's definitely been around until recently, if not.
Yeah,
still.
It was like a Toronto staple. Like
yeah,
everyone recorded.
But
there.
We had at the time we had done Nothing and Nowhere. We were doing an EP for Repo at the time, I think, we were just gonna do an EP. We got the opportunity to go into Phase One. We worked with George Sierra on six songs.
Yeah.
And then that was kind of that was still an independent release, though, I think.
Yeah, we.
And then we got signed off that.